The Democratic candidates for governor revealed their action plans today, giving Hawaii voters more insight into their roadmap for the state's future. Christine Ueno talked to both candidates and has details. Chris?
Joe, both candidates are confident and committed to their plans and believe it's more than just a campaign document.
What's the direction the state should go in over the next 4 years? That's what both Democratic candidates for governor answered today, each revealing their action plan if elected.
What I think of them is solid planks in a platform based on Hawaii's future. That platform is as solid as it can be today, with a $664 million positive balance to build on.
Governor Abercrombie's plan is called Charting Tomorrow, and he says it's no different from his New Day plan, which he introduced 4 years ago. Here's a quick look at some of the highlights. The governor is proposing to provide $100 million to a fund that could be used for workforce housing and to help the homeless. He wants to avoid broad-based tax increases for businesses and wants to exceed the 2030 goal of 40% renewable energy in Hawaii. His opponent, Senator David Ige, calls his plan engineering Hawaii's future.
This is not just a campaign vehicle that appears once every 4 years. It would be something that would drive the state administration, state government for the duration of the term.
The senator wants to collect back taxes to help balance the budget. He also wants to expand tourism by getting immigration pre-clearance for more international travelers. And he wants Medicaid recipients to receive services similar to Kupuna Care. One of the issues they disagree on? Education and whether to use public money to fund private preschools. And it's no secret that the candidates have different traits. Senator Ige says he's more of a listener, but he also told me he's still an effective communicator.
If I had the opportunity to meet and talk with every voter in the state of Hawaii, I'm convinced I would win in a landslide.
I mentioned the senator's statement to the governor.
Any comment?
That's very optimistic.
And if you'd like to know more about their action plans, just go to our website where we've posted links to both documents. Christina Ueno, KHON2 News.
KHON2 is Hawaii's election headquarters. We'll have live coverage of the primary election on air and online at KHON2.com. Join us on Saturday, August 9th.